Welcome back to Humble for Christ.
Recently, I got invited to do a study, and the study was on the book of Ruth. So, learning things about the book of Ruth. And the first part of Ruth that we read was, of course, the beginning. You know, I thought they were going to mix it up. Sometimes they do that in Bible studies, but this one, it starts from the beginning to the end of Ruth. So, just understood, there's only four chapters, but they're going to break each chapter down. That's exciting. Now, they read the first part of Ruth, but not all the way. They read chapter 1, verse 1 through about, 18. Yeah. So, verse 1 through 18 was about, first, the beginning part of it. Verse 1 through 5 was about the fact that Naomi had lost everything. Naomi lost her, you know, she lost her husband, her sons, and she was left with her two daughter-in-laws. So, after she was left just all alone by herself, as far as her blood family, it was just her by herself. And so, she came to her daughter-in-laws, and she was like, you know, you guys, just let me see. I'll read to you what she said. It says, but on the way, Naomi said to her daughter-in-laws, it says on the way because Naomi and Ruth were to return back to where they came from. So, because she had heard that the Lord had blessed his people in Judah by giving them food and crops again. So, that's where Naomi, Ruth, and even Orpah, they were going together. But on the way there, Naomi said to her two daughter-in-laws, go back to your mother's homes and may the Lord reward you for your kindness to your husbands and to me. May the Lord bless you with the security of another marriage. Then she kissed them goodbye, and they all broke down and wept. And the daughter-in-laws said to Ruth, they said, no, we're not leaving you. Like, we don't want to go. We want to go with you. We don't want to go back to our home. And so, I like that part of the scripture. But I'm going to share that with you in a minute. Let me read what else that I grabbed from it. It says, but Naomi replied, why should you go on with me? Can I still give birth to other sons and could grow up to be your husbands? Would you wait for them? No, my daughters, return to your parents' home, for I am too old to marry again. And even if it were possible, and I were to get married and bear sons, then what? Would you wait for them to grow up? Would you wait to marry them? No, you wouldn't. Why would you? You know? Of course not. You know, then she says, these things are far more bitter for me than for you, because the Lord himself has raised his fist against me. Now, to me, that was a scripture that said, wow, like she felt so... She felt so swallowed by grief that she literally felt like God had his fist and was going like this, like, Ruth, Naomi, that's how Naomi felt. She was engulfed in grief. And I liked to read that part because even in her grief, she told her daughter-in-laws that she hoped for success for them. She hoped for a better life for them. She wanted them to leave her, to go away from her, go out and remarry and love again and have children and have a life. And that's incredible, you know. Come here. And that's incredible. So I thought to myself, like, oh man, I want to share that because I'm reading it and it's awesome. But the amazing thing that I wanted to share with you guys is the grief part, because even though she was in her grief, even though she was in her grief like she was, it stood out to me the most because, like I said, inside of her ball of calamity and destruction and chaos that was going on in her mind. I don't have nobody. I lost my husband. I lost my two sons. They had wives and now their wives have nobody. What am I going to do? I don't know. You know, I don't have nothing to give these ladies. You know, she still reached inside. It's like she reached into the spirit man and said, Lord, help me to give them hope to live. help me to give them hope to want better for their lives and want more for their lives. And I thought that was incredible because, you know, on a regular basis, it's hard for us as human beings to encourage one another. It's hard for us as human beings to just be there for each other and reach out to each other. And here this woman is probably, you know, 70, 80 or something like that years old. And she's encouraging her daughter-in-laws in a hard spot in her life. She's encouraging them, loving on them, you know, giving them a push, helping them to go, telling them to continue, don't stop for me, you know. And I just thought that was incredible because it's something that we all need to practice. And that's a lesson that you can learn just from Naomi. Now, after we pass the part of Naomi's grief and we get to her conversation with her daughter-in-laws, this is fascinating to me, okay? Because one of the daughter-in-laws left. Now, both of them, I had said it, that both of them told her, this is chapter 1, verse 10, they said, no, they said, we want to go with you to your people. This is what both of the daughter-in-laws said, Orpah and Ruth. And so, but guess which one ended up leaving? Orpah ended up leaving. Orpah said, like, you know, she gave her a kiss goodbye and she left. She went back home to her family and where she felt safe, where she felt secure, where she felt like, okay, I have a chance of remarrying, so I'm going to go, you know, I'm going to go back to my home. And that's what she did, like, meaning, and to me that meant that for her, she loved her, but her love wasn't that intense for her to where she's like, you know, she's like, well, my family's still alive, so I'm just going to go back where I was, you know. It didn't dawn on her that, okay, this woman lost everyone, so let me stay with her. No, she thought to herself, like, I mean, I can't give her anything if I don't have anything to give, so she left. But through all this, and this conversation, and, you know, them waving bye to Orpah, and Ruth is still standing there, right? Ruth is still next to Naomi. And it says this in the Word of God, in chapter 1, verse 14. It says, and again they wept together, and Orpah kissed her mother-in-law goodbye. But Ruth clung tightly to Naomi. Look, Naomi said to her, your sister-in-law has gone back to her people and to her gods. You should do the same. But Ruth replied, don't ask me to leave you and turn back. Wherever you go, I will go. Wherever you live, I will live. Your people will be my people, and your God will be my God. Wherever you die, I will die, and there I will be buried. May the Lord punish me severely if I allow anything but death to separate us. So, anyway, I just thought that was fascinating. Sorry. Give me a second. No, anyway, so I like that part because, hold on, Elena, I'm coming. Yes. Anyway. Okay, let me go see what's going on with this girl in a second. I'm almost done. 2 minutes, less than that. Anyway, so after reading that part, I thought to myself, the love that Ruth had for Naomi was so incredible, right? So strong, so intense, so unconditional, so moving that she thought to herself, like, I don't care where you go in this life. To know that you have nobody and you've been my mother-in-law, I'm going to adopt you as my mom. I'm going to love you unconditionally just like your own sons and your husband loved you. I'm going to love you like that because you have no one. You only have me. So where would I go? Why would I leave? No. Their relationship, their bond was so strong, so unbreakable, that she said, even to death. And this was her mother-in-law. This wasn't her blood mother. This was her mother-in-law. That's incredible. It's incredible because it shows us how much we do need each other in this life, how important and valuable each life is inside of each other, meaning that each person that you know or that you're in contact with has a significant meaning in your life. They have a significant, what's the word? A significant amount of
promise, understanding, connection, depth in your life. You know, they're not just there for a reason. They're not just there for nothing. They're there for a reason, you know. So I think that's incredible, and that's something that we have to remember as people. And a lot of times it's something that we forget. A lot of times we forget to even connect to each other because we're so caught up in everyday life and the things that's going on around us, and phones and TV. And, you know, I'm guilty of it myself. Like, there have been many times, even today, you know, I was caught up in my phone, but I wasn't feeling well. So, I mean, that's not an excuse, you know, still. But I wasn't feeling well. But, you know, I was caught up in my own little world, and it was, and I was bothered at the end of the day, because as a mom, I try to make it a point to spend time with all four of my daughters, and today I didn't do that. Today I didn't. I was just in my bed today because I was just that exhausted. And, you know, I don't take my own excuses as good excuses. I feel like any excuse is not a good excuse unless it's an emergency and I'm in the hospital. Then I don't have a reason to get up. But as long as my daughters are here and I'm alive and well and still in my bed in my home, then I should be getting up. I should be moving around. I should be doing, you know, I should be spending time with them, talking with them, asking them how they're doing, how do they feel, what's going on with them. So it's something that I want to practice every day. And just reading Ruth and hearing about the unconditional love, the unconditional hope and courage that she had for her daughter-in-law, the unconditional love that Ruth had for Naomi, you know, even the choice that Orpah made, it was a conscious decision for herself, because she, you know, she realized that for herself, she was afraid to continue on. So if you have fear in you to continue on, then you shouldn't. As far as certain things, you shouldn't. But if your fear will allow you to change, hold on, mommy gonna give you one. If your fear will push you forward and allow you to keep going, then fine. But if your fear is so overwhelming that you feel like you don't trust the next steps ahead, then you might have to pause and turn back, because that's what Orpah did. But Ruth, Ruth's unconditional love for Naomi is what pushed her to keep going with Naomi. It's what pushed her to keep saying that, I know that my mother-in-law needs someone and I need someone. Yes, go get it from Daddy. Be careful. So anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Sorry for the interruptions. I try not to edit my videos because I really do want to be as real as possible, and I want people to realize I'm a person. You know, I mess up. You know, look at my hair as well. I don't even care. It's all right. It's all good. You know, this is life, and I'm glad to share life with you guys. And comment below if you have anything to say about the video, or if you, you know, have anything to say about the story of Ruth in the Bible, or just anything to say on unconditional love, hope, encouragement, grief and loss, and finding hope and having faith in loss and in grief, you know. All right, you guys, but thanks for watching, and I hope you like and subscribe to my channel. Please share my videos, and have a blessed day. Bye. I see a shadow.